Dr. Trehan, do you have concrete ideas on what should be done to bring down the spread of the disease, to bring down the flow of patients to hospitals such as yours or AIIMS or elsewhere? And there's a big debate which industry is very worried about at this time about whether another lockdown is inevitable. We spoke to the Chief Minister of Delhi yesterday. He and the Chief Minister of Maharashtra said essentially the same thing. If our hospital facilities get run over, we have no option but to go for a lockdown. Dr. Trehan.
So, you know, we are staring at really a very, very, very serious situation, much worse than we were in the first spike that we saw. So the question right now is that, as the previous speakers have outlined already, one, of course, the vaccine is going to be essential as part of the armamentarium. The second thing is, like, before I advocate a country lockdown or a city lockdown, there are two things we can do, and that is appeal to the public, and this should be a continuous appeal day and night, because this is time to actually be scared for yourself. And if people are scared for themselves and they can be nudged into actually practicing the COVID appropriate behavior religiously, like we do with anything that is related to religion, we shall then be able to break the chain, or at least make our individual effort to do that. The second thing is that, like the previous Dr. Guleria said, cut down gatherings. There is no reason that we should allow marriages with 200, 150 people. We should just limit it to 5, 10 members of the family. Any gathering, no social gathering should be allowed. Yes, there will be some fallout on entertainment and on the food industry and all that, yes. But that is a small price to pay as compared to locking down the country, because that will be economically a major disaster for individuals, the people who are dependent totally on their daily bread. So I think those three things that have been repeated already, the appropriate behavior, the cutting down on all gatherings, and vaccine, these are the three elements that must be enforced right away and locked down selectively.
TV Narendran, Uday Kotak spoke of ramping up capacity for manufacturing vaccines. Now, this is not really like any other industrial sector where you can divert plants and factories and start producing more vaccines. Do you have any concrete ideas about how you think this can be done? You're working across pharmaceutical companies, vaccine manufacturers. Have you heard back from them? Is there a desire to move existing vaccine manufacturing capacity for this national ramp up for manufacturing the COVID vaccine?
Yeah, so thanks, Rahul. I think what I'm hearing is there is capacity in the country which is not fully utilized, or which can be ramped up much more than it is today by the existing vaccine manufacturers. So I think that's one. We should exploit that. It may not solve the problem fully, but it can get us to a better place than we are today. And I think so that's a discussion between the government and the vaccine manufacturers, and CII has also been facilitating that. CII has also said that the private sector is also happy to import vaccines if required, because we can help in the process of augmenting the supply in the country. So I think these are two things, and appropriate behavior. I think these three will certainly help us. I think in all these options, we have not fully leveraged the potential that there is.
But none of you have spoken so far about the gorilla in the room, the 300-pound L word, the lockdown. Sanjeev Bajaj, we saw how the first lockdown broke the back of the Indian economy. Do you think it's inevitable that there be another lockdown? If there is another lockdown, what form should it take? How can we try and prevent the spread of the virus to the extent possible without killing the economy again?
Rahul, it's not inevitable at all. While we have some very high cases in Mumbai, in Pune and a few other locations, it's still limited in terms of high numbers to a few states. It can, of course, increase. And that's where, as CII and as the earlier speakers have said, we need urgent action. We need to take all the safety precautions that we've been talking about for the last 1 year. We need to stop gatherings. That is a single biggest super spreader event. More than 10 people, whether meetings, any other private gatherings, public gatherings, must be stopped. As far as people are concerned, at the workspace, organized offices, whether it's factories, that's where things are more organized. We can keep people safe. It removes those many people from public spaces, giving our police and others some breathing space as well. So that must be encouraged. People must work from home where possible. Public transportation, as already said, focus on 30% capacity. We just need to wear our mask, make sure the spread events get controlled. And this will come back in control with all the other things required. So we anyway, in places like Maharashtra, we need a couple of weeks for all the action already taken. The lockdown is going to hurt us significantly on the economic side. Let us remember, last year, our government and RBI tremendously supported the economy. But we are not the US, we are not the UK, we can't freely print money. We will not be able to do the same thing again. And that's why, as CII, as business, we need to work hand in hand with the government. We need to do our bit by being open, by taking all the necessary responsibilities. But each Indian has to take their responsibilities seriously.